H-1B and unemployed, how to maintain visa status in the U.S. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, many individuals holding H-1B work visas in the United States are having difficulty keeping their jobs, especially in the service industry and in some hard-hit specialty fields. If you are unemployed or worry about being laid off or furloughed in the future, what can you do to keep your valid visa status in the U.S.? There are several scenarios. First, if you find a new job that sponsors H-1B work visas, and the new employer can file H-1B application to the USCIS for you promptly, either before you leave the current job or during the 60-day grace period, you will be able to start working for the new employer even before the new H-1B application is approved for up to 240 days. Second, if you or your spouse are qualified for the National Interest Waiver, NIW, you can file the NIW I-140 petition, and you may also file I-485 Adjustment of Status application concurrently with the I-140. This is allowed unless both you and your spouse were born in mainland China or India. With I-485 applications submitted to the USCIS and pending, you can legally stay in the United States without any other visa status, and you can also obtain Employment Authorization Document, EAD, to work for almost any employer after you file I-765 application together with the I-485. Our law firm, New Weiming Law Group, specializes in NIW, and we have helped many, many applicants to obtain NIW approvals. Now that a lot of researchers, scientists, doctors, and professionals cannot go to their office or laboratory to work, there's more time to prepare the NIW application, and there's good reason to submit the NIW as soon as possible. Third, if your current H-1B visa status is going to expire because of change in employment status, and if you cannot find suitable new employers to support H-1B and cannot file NIW, you can still consider other options. For example, you can file I-539 application for change of visa status to B-2. The application can take several months to process. During this time, you can stay in the U.S. and wait for the adjudication of the pending B-2 application, and in the meantime look for other opportunities. The I-539 application usually requires you to show you have sufficient funds to support yourself during the time period. Recently, the USCIS announced that they will be more flexible when reviewing B-2 applications. For example, even if you have already lost valid visa status and there's a gap in your immigration status history, you may still file the I-539 application for changing to B-2 visa status and get approved. Of course, there are other options available, such as changing to a dependent visa status, including H-4, F-2, L-2, J-2, O-3, etc. If your spouse holds corresponding H-1B, F-1, L-1, J-1, or O-1 visa status, you may also consider changing to F-1, J-1, or O-1 visa status yourself. In summary, even during this difficult time, even if your H-1B visa status is affected by change in employment or is going to be affected, there are still many options. The pandemic will eventually pass, and as described above, you can find ways to maintain valid legal status in the United States, including concurrent filing of NIW and I-485. For more information, please contact us by email to info@nwmlaw.com or visit our website at www.nwmlaw.com. Thank you and best wishes!